Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of power steering pump failure. Power steering pumps are a critical component on vehicles that use hydraulic power steering systems. Now, these hydraulic power steering systems are common on vehicles manufactured between about 1960 up until 2015. In the modern era, many manufacturers have switched to electronic power steering, which does not utilize a power steering pump. Now, power steering pumps are responsible for sending pressurized hydraulic fluid through the steering system to allow the wheels and steering wheel to turn a lot easier. Without that hydraulic assistance, it can be very challenging and require a lot of force to turn the steering wheel of your vehicle. So it's critical to ensure your power steering system and pump are working correctly so you can properly steer and safely maneuver your vehicle. So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common signs and symptoms of power steering pump failure. Number one on the list, we have leaking power steering fluid. The fluids used in the power steering pump are actually hydraulic fluids, but they're commonly known as simply power steering fluids. These fluids are often a very clear, light color and typically have a slight pinkish or reddish hue to them and may sometimes also be a very light brown color. So if you're noticing that kind of leak with that color under the vehicle, especially around the area of your power steering pump, that can indicate that you have a leaking pump and ultimately a power steering pump failure. Now, one final thing to mention on leaking power steering fluid is there are a lot of different components that can cause a power steering fluid leak. So a lot of hoses, your pressurized hoses, any of those can actually develop a power steering fluid leak. So just because you're leaking power steering fluid doesn't guarantee that it's actually the pump itself. So if you do notice those leaks, it's important to see if you could locate specifically where that power steering fluid is actually leaking from. Moving on to our second common sign and symptom, we have that the steering wheel is very hard to turn, especially at lower speeds. I talked about this a little bit in the introduction and how it's critical to ensure safe maneuvering and handling of your vehicle. So without the power steering pump, it can be very, very hard to turn the steering wheel, and it will require a lot of force to do so, especially at lower speeds. If you've ever driven a vehicle with no power steering system at all, you likely know and are familiar with how challenging it can be to get that wheel to turn, especially if you're sitting at a dead standstill or idling at a couple miles an hour. Usually once you get up to 15, 20 plus miles an hour, it becomes relatively easy to turn the steering wheel, but you'll likely still notice that it feels a lot heavier and still requires more force than normal. So if you're noticing those symptoms, it can be a sign that your power steering pump is no longer working effectively, or in cases where it's severe and really hard to turn the wheel, that could mean that something has failed completely or you have absolutely no power steering fluid left in the system. Ultimately, if you're noticing that the steering wheel is a lot more challenging to turn, one important thing to do is check the fluids. Low fluids can also cause this, so just because the wheel is harder to turn doesn't mean it's definitely the pump. Speaking of the importance of checking the power steering fluid levels, that leads us into our third common sign of power steering pump failure, and that is low power steering fluid. So again, if you open up that reservoir and notice it's very low in there, or maybe don't see any power steering fluid at all, that can be a sign that the low power steering fluid could be causing some of the other symptoms you're noticing. However, a lot of the times, if that fluid is getting low, it could actually be the pump that is leaking the fluid and causing it to be low. So that's another thing to double check. Again, if you see that the levels in the power steering reservoir are very low, oftentimes that's due to a leak, and then tracking down the leak will be the next important step. Moving on to our fourth common sign and symptom, we have dirty or contaminated power steering fluid. So much like the low fluid levels, any dirty or contaminated power steering fluid could indicate an issue with the power steering pump or something else in the power steering system. A lot of the times, if it is the pump, you may notice metal flakes or pieces in the power steering fluid, and that could indicate that you have an issue with the pump internally and it's wearing down and grinding down and starting to run into issues. So again, if you're noticing that old, dirty, or contaminated power steering fluid, it could be a sign that the pump is on its way out. For our fifth and final common symptom of power steering pump failure, we have odd or strange noises coming from the steering of the vehicle. So a couple different sounds you may hear are groaning or grinding-like noises, which typically those sounds indicate a problem with the power steering pump. However, you may also notice squealing or kind of higher pitched noises, whining sounds coming from the power steering system. And a lot of the times that can be caused actually by the drive belt or the pulleys, which are actually responsible for driving the power steering pump. So depending on what sound you may be noticing from the power steering system, that can help point and guide you in the right direction. Again, any kind of groaning or grinding sounds often indicate an issue with the pump itself, whereas whining or squealing sounds can indicate an issue with the drive belt or pulleys. So ultimately, that wraps up the most common signs and symptoms of power steering pump failure. Now, when it comes to actually fixing and replacing the power steering pump, once you have identified this as the definite cause of your problems, what does it look like in terms of actually repairing and replacing that pump? So the power steering pump on most vehicles will range anywhere from about $150 up to $400. And when it comes to labor for replacing the pump, this can vary significantly depending on the specific vehicle in question. But a lot of the times it's a roughly 1.5 to 3 hour job. So if you end up at a repair shop, that's likely another roughly $200 to $500 in labor costs. So ultimately, replacing the power steering pump typically falls in the ballpark of about $400 to $800. And that really does depend on each vehicle in question and your specific location. It can be a little more or less expensive. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more. Thanks, everyone.